It's true that you use most of your muscles in your body to swim. But there's a group of muscles that is essential for swimming more than any other. That is the core muscles. Just look at these amazing men and women competing at the Paralympic Games. If they didn't have strong core muscles, they wouldn't be able to move in a straight line, and yet they do. So, these muscles, the core muscles, have three important functions when you are swimming. Direction. When you pull in freestyle or in backstroke, what keeps you in line is your core muscles. If you didn't use them, then you would be zigzagging. And if you didn't use your core in breaststroke or butterfly, there would be no transferring of potential energy from your arms to your feet, as we talked about in our part 6 of Physics of Swimming video. And you wouldn't move very fast. Your core is what helps you move where you want to move. It is also what keeps your legs from sinking if you engage it properly. Rotation. When you swim freestyle and backstroke, you are also constantly rotating your body. This helps to put your arms in a better position to pull, but it also helps the pull. By rotating your body, you are also pulling your arms when you tighten your obliques. Base of support. Unlike land-based athletes who have a stable surface to push off from, you have to generate your own base of support. That base of support is your core. That's where the power to move your body with your arms and legs comes from. Without core muscles, you would be like a cooked spaghetti with arms and legs moving nowhere in the water. To strengthen your core, check out this playlist that will appear here at the end of the video. If you didn't see last week's video, I just want to remind you that we still have some spots available for both of our camps. Here's a quick summary of our schedule. Day 0, arrival day, pick up from the airport. You will also receive a skills and talents welcome kit. Day 1, we will have our team bonding and our first swimming session and video recordings of your swim. Day 2, another swim session with recordings and technique drills, an afternoon dryland session. We will identify areas of improvement outside the water. Day 3. On this day, we will swim twice, correcting techniques on the specific events that you want to focus on. Day 4. One swimmer at a time during the day will be called to see his or her video to learn what areas he or she can improve the most. Day 5. We will go for a swim. Then, we will focus on your video analysis and making your stroke more efficient, with lots of drills and feedback from us. Day 6. Long swimming practice. You will be called throughout the practice for fast recording. You will be separated into groups so we can give specific training to each group. You will have the rest of the day for yourself. You can go out and explore tourist attractions or simply rest. Day 7. Time to say goodbye. In the next couple of weeks, you will receive a bundle with your full video analysis of your swim during the camp, exercises outside and inside the water to finish correcting your technique to create muscle memory for the correction to be permanent. If this is something you're really interested in, I'll leave links in the description for both of our camps. After you fill out a questionnaire, we will get in contact with you with any questions you have before you make a decision. See you soon. Swim fast.